This is an executive summary of the best leadership lessons from Admiral McRaven's book, Make Your Bed, Little Things That Can Change Your Life and Maybe the World. In May of 2014, Admiral McRaven gave the graduation speech at the University of Texas. McRaven discussed 10 leadership and life principles which would help those graduates to change their lives and maybe the world. This book gives more context and details for these 10 principles. Although these leadership principles are not earth-shattering or new, the book frames each of these principles through personal stories and experiences while going through SEAL training and during his service in the Navy. And this is what makes the book so fun to read and so easy to understand. Let's get started. Navy SEAL training is called Basic Underwater Demolition, or BUDS. At BUDS, you have to make your bed every morning to exact specifications. You don't get rewarded if you make your bed correctly, but you do get punished if you don't make it correctly. Making your bed is your first task completed each day, and it gives you a small sense of accomplishment, and it puts you in the right frame of mind. Even if you have a terrible day, you will always come back to a clean and properly made bed. McRaven tells the story of his time in Iraq immediately after Saddam Hussein was captured. As a special operations commander, every day Admiral McRaven would go in to check on Saddam to make sure he was healthy and being treated in accordance with the Geneva Convention. Interestingly enough, McRaven noticed that Saddam Hussein did not make his bed. Lesson number one, if you want to change your life and maybe the world, start off your day with one task complete. You better make your bed. During Navy SEAL training, you spend a lot of time working in small boat teams. Inevitably, a member of your team will get sick or is exhausted, and the other team members have to row harder. They have to share their food. They have to do more than their share of the work to make the boat crew a success. Lesson number two, you can't go it alone. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, you have to find someone to help you paddle. As a young ROTC midshipman and aspiring Navy SEAL, young William McRaven waited in the hallway of the headquarters of BUDS for a lieutenant to meet with him to answer questions about the SEAL training program. While waiting in the hallway, McRaven saw a slight, almost frail, civilian-looking man also viewing the historical Navy pictures on the wall. McRaven thought to himself, how in the world could that skinny guy ever think he has what it takes to make it through SEAL training? It made McRaven feel good that he was clearly stronger and more prepared than another man to endure the rigors of Navy SEAL training. McRaven was ushered into the office of the SEAL lieutenant and they began to discuss SEAL training. A few minutes later, the slight, almost frail, civilian-looking man from the hallway popped inside the office. The lieutenant, speaking with McRaven, introduced the man as Lieutenant Tommy Norris, a Navy SEAL who earned the Congressional Medal of Honor in Vietnam, 1972. Lesson number three, only the size of your heart matters. If you want to change your life, and maybe the world, only measure someone by their heart. In SEAL training, you are punished by being sent into the cold water of the Pacific Ocean and then made to roll in the sand until every square inch of your body, head, and face is covered in sand. Once you have done this, you are called a sugar cookie. The sand is scratchy and coarse. Being a sugar cookie is absolutely miserable, but it is not the end of the world. During training, a SEAL instructor told McRaven to make himself a sugar cookie. Once he made himself into a sugar cookie, the instructor asked McRaven if he knew why he was a sugar cookie. The instructor further explained that life is not fair and sometimes you just have to move on. Whether it is a car accident, the wrong place at the wrong time, disease, injuries, or death, we are all vulnerable to unfairness and/or chance and unforeseen circumstances. We can't let these events get us down. We must remain positive and keep pressing on towards our goal. Lesson number four, life is not fair, move on. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, get over being a sugar cookie. SEAL candidates who fail to maintain the standards of training are given extra physical training each afternoon. This is called the circus. Going to the circus is often a downward spiral. If you fail to complete the swim in 2 hours and then you're punished by being sent to the circus, the next day you are even more exhausted and can't complete the swim in time. McRaven and his swim buddy failed to complete a swim on time. They were sent to the circus. But after several iterations of the circus, McRaven and his swim buddy began to get stronger and to get faster. They took something made to be negative and they turned it into a positive. They got tougher. Eventually, McRaven and his swim buddy finished the final swim of the course in first place. Lesson number 5. Failure can make you stronger. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, don't be afraid of the circus. Check out this image of one of the Navy SEALs obstacle courses. It's a big deal. The slide for life in the Buds obstacle course was high and steep. McRaven slid down it feet first, like the soldier in this image, but finished the obstacle course with a slow time. Eventually, he rounded up the courage to slide down the rope head first, like the Marine in this image. By doing so, he was significantly increasing his risk of injury, but also he significantly decreased his time. Sometimes in life, you have to take risks in order to be successful. This applies to negotiating obstacle courses, but also when making business decisions or rescuing hostages in the global war on terror. Lesson number 6, you must dare greatly. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, slide down the obstacle head first. SEALs swim alone and unafraid in the most troublesome waters of this world. During training off the San Clemente Island, McRaven remembers swimming in a breeding ground of the great white shark. Yet he had to be brave and courageous. He had to accomplish his mission. He could not back down simply because of the presence of sharks. Lesson number 7, stand up to the bullies. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, don't back down from the sharks. During the culmination of dive phase, SEAL candidates had to swim 2,000 meters underwater into San Diego Bay, find a specific ship, place training mines on its keel, and return to the beach. To make matters worse, this training event was done at night. SEAL candidates were told that they must rise above their fears in the darkness. You must be your best. The water was cold and dark. That night, you couldn't even see your hand in front of your face. It was impossible to see anything. Lesson number 8, rise to the occasion. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, be your very best at the darkest moments. During Wednesday of Hell Week, in the Tijuana mudflaps of Southern California, McRaven found himself up to his neck in the cold mud. The instructors told the SEAL candidates that they could all warm up with a fire and enjoy some hot coffee and soup if only 5 SEALs would quit. Suddenly, one of the SEALs began to sing. Then others joined in. Then everyone began to sing. The instructors threatened the students and yelled for them to stop, but they did not. The chief instructor stopped yelling and walked away with a smile on his face. The SEALs had passed the test. They continued on in the face of adversity. They were unstoppable. Lesson number 9, give people hope. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, start singing when you are up to your neck in mud. If you want to quit Navy SEAL training, all you have to do is to ring the bell 3 times. But if you do, you will regret it for the rest of your life. Life constantly puts you in situations where quitting seems like the right thing to do, but you can't do it. You must persevere. Think about all that William McRaven has accomplished during his 30 years as a Navy SEAL and as the commander of JSOC and Special Operations Command. Imagine all of the bad guys and the terrorists who are no longer a threat to us and to our families because of his efforts and his leadership. The world is safer because Bill McRaven persevered when times got tough. Lesson number 10, never quit. If you want to change your life and maybe the world, don't ever ring the bell. I hope you enjoyed this executive summary of the best leadership lessons from Admiral McRaven's book, Make Your Bed, Little Things That Can Change Your Life and Maybe the World. This book was a quick read with solid principles and fascinating stories. I recommend this book to anyone. Buy it through Amazon or listen to the book for free via Audible. The hyperlinks are below. Thanks for learning, and don't forget to subscribe and share with a friend who also needs to know this.